Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, we're going to dig into paginated reports a little bit, looking at parameters. How do we use them? And how do we know what's actually being sent to that parameter using the paginated video in a Power BI report? Let's dig in. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, I've been getting into paginated reports a little bit, was working with a customer. They had some requirements for using direct query. Actually, we shifted over to a paginated report and it sent me down this rabbit hole of what you can actually do with these and how do you submit more advanced items with it. So I wanted to share that with you. This is the first video. There's probably gonna be two or three in this series. The first thing we want to look at are the parameters themselves. How do we use the parameters with the paginated visual? And how do we know what's actually being sent to those parameters? All right, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So I have a beautiful Power BI report. This is just a simple bar chart. I've got a couple slicers up here. And then what I've got, if I go to the details page, is I have a paginated report already set up and it's doing a couple of things. So we've got data here. We've got group, category, name, color. This is all great. And actually, you know what? Let's just delete this and start over so you can see the full experience. And we're just gonna create a paginated visual on the report. I'm gonna say connect to report. You're first gonna wanna select a report that you've got. We're going to go to set parameters, and these parameters are defined in the paginated report itself. So if I go to the paginated report, you'll see that I've got two parameters that are set up. If I go into my data set, you'll see that these parameters are linked, and inside of my query, I'm using these for the color and sales territory group. And I've got some default values set up for this. Once that's published to the service, it'll connect up. I'm going to say, I want to ignore the default and I want to use this Power BI field, but I can't click. What's going on? Why isn't this working? So the first thing you have to do is, let's go back out here with the visual selected. You'll see this parameter well. Any fields that you want to be able to use with those parameter dropdowns have to be listed here. So what I'm using is I want my group and I want my product color. And if I go back into edit, select set parameters. Now, if I do default, I now have these available to me. So let's wire up color and we'll wire up group. The other thing you're going to notice here are the values that are listed here. Now I got caught up a little bit and I was thinking, well, this shows me the values that are actually going to be there. I don't know why I thought this, but I was thinking that it's just going to pull all the values from the dimension table for that field because I dragged that field into the list. That's not actually how it works. We'll look at group because there's three values here: Europe, North America, and Pacific. Remember, this is in the context of a visual. So this is a filter on the page. You also notice I have it set up for drill through. So on the groups, let me filter this down to just Europe. And you'll notice that the values changed automatically. That makes sense. The filter context is gonna be applied to the visual. That's gonna filter down the list of values that go back to the report server. Another way you can tell what's going on here. So let me go ahead and see report. See it filtered down to Europe. Let me remove this filter and apply changes. And now you can see all three groups are listed. Great. That's exactly what I want. Also, you'll notice that I had to hit apply changes. I'm just going to come over to the format pane here and say auto apply filters. I don't want to have to click that every time. So I can see the values as I'm selecting the parameter list, but maybe I've already selected it. I'm actually looking at the report, but I'm modifying a few things. And I want to verify what values are actually going back to the paginated report. So we can also come up to the ellipsis and go to show as a table. And when we do that, these are the values that are going to go back for that column. So you'll see Europe, and then these are all the colors that are going to go. And you've got North America, these are all the colors, and then Pacific, and then these are all the colors. So this is a way you can validate what values are going back for those fields. So if I go back to the sales report, let's go select black, and then I also want to choose North America, and I'm going to go and drill through details. Now you'll notice here in my drill through, I'm filtering by black, and I'm filtering by North America. You'll see that it's filtered North America. Go into accessories, we'll see that it's black only, and if we go to show as a table, you'll notice that there's only one value for each one that are going back. Pretty straightforward. But I wanted to just highlight this as you're working with a paginated report and trying to figure out parameter values and what's actually going back and forth. That's how you can actually go figure out what those values are and wire them up for the paginated report and drag those fields in. Now, here's another thing that's cool. So I've only got group and color, and those are the only two parameters I have, but let me actually add category name. And you'll see here that category name now is in this list of values that are part of this filter context. So if I were to go back and let's go to edit, set parameters. If I choose color, now I can choose category name, right? And you'll see those values. So as long as I just add these values into this parameter list, it's available from a Paginator report perspective, and those associated values will be available to the visual. If I haven't wired it up to a parameter, those values never get sent, but just be aware that it's still gonna probably be querying the engine to get that data for that given visual. Nothing earth shattering, pretty straightforward. Parameters, the values that are being used with them associated with that data model. I just wanted to get this teed up for you so that it adds context to the other videos I'm going to be doing. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Are you using Paginator reports? Are you mucking around with parameters? Did you get confused about those? I'd love to hear it down in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.